Go.
Okay, this is a dentist who graduated in the 1990s with debt. Oh, it's manageable. A little tough, but manageable. All right, off 1990s debt. Next, 2000s debt. In the purple. Oh, this is my generation. Not easy, but the cost to go to dental school, probably at the high end, $200,000. Okay, off. 2010 debt, green sweatshirt. Oh man, dental school pricing has gotten doubled, even though new grads are making the same. Dentist income is stagnant. Okay, 2020 debt. Everybody on here.
Oh,
next. Whatever. Good. Good.
Yeah,
Drew, can you get on?
Drew, get on the back.
Get on the back.
Okay. Hold on, Drew. There's 2021 debt. Oh, that's so tough. Thanks, guys. That's awesome, Hudson.
Go.
Dentisting is not easy. Dentisting is difficult. Doing full contact arts and crafts on people that do not want to be there or pay for it can make any dentist stressed and want to cry on the inside. I should know, I am one. My name is Paul Dr. Nacho Goodman, and my goal in life is to help you increase success, decrease stress, and reduce the number of times you feel like crying inside. This is the cry inside monster. What makes us want to cry inside? Sometimes you're doing a class two, and that little ring thingy that you stretch out onto the tooth, it flies across the room and pings around on the floor. You want to cry inside. When you look at your assistant and say, oh, can I have another ring thingy? And you look in the box and the only sterilized one is a mangled pedo ring. And you're doing a 15 MO on a tooth that looks like a mushroom. And you have to say, perfect, just the one I wanted. Your amazing team, they're an amazing team. They do amazing things, but they do an amazing job fighting over who took the last roll of paper towels. Makes you want to cry inside. You get an insurance EOB back in 2022. You look at it and you say, is this pricing from 1982? Because the insurance company is paying you less. That makes you want to cry inside. Well, we have part of the answer. Can we fix it? No. But what we can do is make you 23.8% less, not just the show, less likely to cry inside. What we are going to do is help you answer the toughest questions, the challenging questions patients ask, like, why doesn't my insurance cover this? My sister's insurance covers everything. Your sister's insurance covers every world peace. Does her spoiled Guac PPO cover world peace? But you gotta keep that inside and say, oh, sounds like your sister has good insurance. Your sister, they cover 33 veneers on 32 teeth for her. Your sister is not being truthful. We only have insurance this fall. It's going to be recorded, and there are three amazing options for you to partake online. Maybe you just want the recordings. Maybe you want the recordings and bonus Guac. What's bonus Guac? You're gonna find out by texting talk to 215-543-6454. Maybe you want the recordings and loaded nachos, which comes with a custom. Super excited to be here with you guys today, sharing with you how to have the talk with patients about dropping a plan. Right off the bat, we don't say drop in our practice, say shifting status. And when you drop a plan or shift status, maybe it's one plan, maybe it's 10 plans, maybe you're thinking about it. I'm not here to tell you to drop all your plans or take all the plans. I'm here to share with you, make a plan about your plans. And my experience as a dentist of 20 years being in network and now out of network, they come with pros and cons. The more aware we are, the more prepared we are, the better we can do. One of my regrets, one of the things I wish I did earlier was to
implement a membership club. We did it a few years ago. I think we're up to over 300 patients. I wish I did it sooner. We have awesome Nacho sponsors that can help you implement a membership club into your practice. If you would like to connect with them and do a complimentary demo, just text club to 215-798-9897. My Nacho disclaimer is I am not recommending you drop or sign up for a plan. I'm recommending you develop the verbal skills and insurance knowledge to figure out how insurance best fits into your practice happiness. I'm so thrilled to be here with you live. I'm so thrilled people are watching in with me on a Sunday fun day. My family's coming back from the shore. We have some plans later. I'm doing some Nacho content before. And if you're watching in on demand, glad that you are here. I want to share with you up front, I'm not recommending you drop or sign up for a plan. I'm recommending you develop the verbal skills and insurance knowledge to figure out how insurance best fits into your practice happiness, not the practice happiness of your best friend, not the practice happiness of a Facebook dentist, your practice happiness. I have an amazing friend, Dr. Todd Fleischman, who's going to be part of this resource we're putting together. He's as fee for service as you get, totally fee for service. I'm out of network. I wouldn't call us fee for service. We don't require payment upfront for every single thing we do. We still work with the patient's insurance plans, but we do not adjust our fees for it. Then I have Dr. Travis Campbell, who's in network with many PPOs and has the equivalent of a solo GP practice in Texas that collects over $2 million a year in network with many plans. So there's a variety of ways to be successful. Do not like the phrase variety of ways to skin a cat. I don't know where that came from. It seems kind of unpleasant. So there's a variety of ways to be successful. If you would like a resource to train you and your team to onboard new team members, text talk to 215-798-9897. You can learn how to do this in a fun, affordable, and powerful way, whether you are totally free for service out of network and in network or in in-network dental practice with plans. I also put together training videos. When earlier this year, we shifted status with our biggest insurance plan, our biggest spoiled Guac PPO. So my team's like, so many patients are asking questions. The insurance plan sent letters that kind of say like this joke here, your dentist hates you, leave the practice. So patients get upset, teams get confused. Give people the tools they need to be successful, to talk about dental insurance in a confident and caring way. I'm here to deliver value to you at this webinar. You don't have to buy anything else or text anything else. You're going to get value. You're going to get it right now because one of the main things that I share with my practice, my team, is to call dental insurance a coupon. What does my insurance cover? That's a great question. A lot of patients ask us that. Dental insurance works a lot like a coupon that has benefits, but also restrictions. Like, you know, like blackout dates on airline miles, or when you go for a sale at a store and your brand is not on sale, restrictions like that. We are going to do the best job possible to maximize the benefit of your coupon. So right there, there's like seven sentences you can say to someone who's you're in network with, out of network with. Spoiler alert, my awesome friend, Dr. Todd Fleischman, he's totally out of network and he gets so many questions about dental insurance every day as a fee-for-service provider. So you want to prepare your team to do that. If you would like to see these training videos and have your team watch them, totally free, just text insurance to 215-798-9897. That should say 215-798-9897 and we'll text that back to you. So let's talk about a checklist for success here. Having to talk with your dental patients and shifting status. And I would absolutely love if you ask me questions in the Q&A. I'm just here at Nacho Headquarters, 1500 Walnut. Come and visit us someday. We're having an awesome in-person C events this fall. One on restorative dentistry, one on patient-centered care and profitability. If you'd like to learn about those events, just text Travis to 215-543-6454. But let's go over our checklist for having the talk with patients about shifting status with their insurance plan. One, be proactive in explaining how dental insurance really works, how it works like a coupon. Use that phrase, people get coupons. I have this coupon. I'm from New Jersey, the Bed Bath & Beyond coupon. You don't go in and say, I want the store. You say, oh, I can save 20% on trinkets, but I'm still gonna have to pay something myself. One of the things I've shared when we have patients, long-term patients that have been in network with a plan for us and we shift status, and I get that they're disappointed, expect disappointment. It's normal. Hey, if you were the patient, you'd be disappointed, frustrated, confused. Say, hey, Millie, totally get that you're frustrated. The reason we are doing this is because we do not want your dental insurance plan to have a seat at the table when deciding what is best for your teeth. Then just pause. We do not want your dental insurance plan to have a seat at the table when deciding what is best for your teeth. Seat at the table is a reference to my good friend, Rob Montgomery, my podcast partner, dental focused attorney, the dentalamigos.com bonus value. If you go to the dentalamigos.com, we have so many episodes on buying practices, hiring associates, surviving and thriving, getting leases. He talks about you do not want your landlord of your dental practice to have a seat at the table when it comes to selling it. So if you've signed a lease, you may be seeing that right now, having signed a lease, that your landlord can impact your practice sale, get that lease looked at. He says, you do not want your landlord to have a seat at the table. So I tell them, share with my patients, I do not want their insurance plan to have a seat at the table when deciding what is best for their teeth. However, and I strive not to say, but so I say, and we will do the best job possible to treat your dental insurance like a coupon. Is that something that makes sense to you? What do you think of that? Conversations are back and forth. Is fast food better than no food? So I am so proud to have created Dental Nachos, the Facebook community. We also have an Instagram. We have a text message or email. So we probably have like a 60,000 member community, August 14th, 2022. That's likely our reach. And I'm so proud to have created it. But I also want to share, someone says something on Dental Nachos, that doesn't mean you have to do it. They don't know your story. They don't know your context. They don't know your finances. So is fast food better than no food? Okay, it's a good question to think about. So if you have insurance plans that you've been taking for years, do not reactively say, I'm annoyed one day, I'm just going to drop them, because that can be disastrous for your practice. Make a plan, get a consultant, look at your marketing, want to go over that. It took me years to figure out how to reframe my relationship with insurance. We didn't go shift status all at once. We chose different plans, which we changed status with, shifted status with along the way. And sometimes it's painful. Sometimes your production goes down. You have to determine what makes me happy as the dental practice owner, what fits into our practice life. I'm giving you tools to have the talk. But if you make a strategy, I highly recommend you do it with purpose. You get advisors to help you and look for resources. The three M's to focus on before shifting status: morale, marketing, membership clubs. Morale, marketing, membership clubs. So practices are like circuses where the animals don't try to eat you, just slowly annoy you to death. I have two, you may have five, you may have one, you may be watching this, and you get what those circuses are like. And circuses could be cool, right? They're showing off, doing all kinds of things. I know there's a lot of negativity about circuses, but when I grew up, I went to circuses, watched The Greatest Showman for the purpose of this, let's just say the acrobats part of the circus, because I totally get that there is some challenges with circuses. I've seen Water for Elephants, I've read the book. So let's talk about the acrobat part of the circus. So you might be showing off and making people say, oh, wow, this practice is awful. But behind the scenes, it's so much effort to run it. This is important. When you shift status with a dental insurance plan, the number of patients that you see each day will likely go down. And will that volume going down, even if you make more money, even if you're just as profitable, be a problem for the hours you work, will be a problem for team morale, will be a problem for your morale. We all know that busy is a feeling, not a fact. I think Dr. Phil said feelings are not facts. But if you're not as busy, is that going to be something that affects your morale? So think about that, dig into that. Market more before major changes. So get with a marketing company and evaluate your marketing. Do some consults. We have marketing sponsors for Dental Nachos that are awesome. You can text marketing to 215-798-9897, and I'll share with you ones that you can connect with. Get an analysis of your marketing. What's your online presence like? Are you doing direct mail? Figure out what you do to be profitable and patient-centered. Patient-centered first, profitable second. I happen to love dental implants, patient-centered first, but they're also profitable. So before we did this, we strategized on how we could bring in more implant patients to make up for the loss of patients and revenue that might leave the practice when we drop the plan. So I know I'm here at Nacho headquarters, 1500 Walnut. You want to send us a gift or welcome? Thanks for being you, Paul. I like coffee, big fan of cold brew. I like these ahas. I always say, what's your aha moment? Aha doesn't sponsor us, but they should one day. I'll pause for a minute. Are there any questions I can answer for you? And maybe you're watching this online and you're thinking of a question. Text me that question to 215-798-9897. But if you're here watching with me on Nacho Zoom TV, I'm going to give us 20 seconds. Type a question in the Q&A. I would love to hear one from you. Will patients leave? A common question. Yes, patients will leave. The relationships we have with our patients come in all shapes and sizes and degree of bondability. We love bonding. Let's talk about bonding. So you know Sally, who you love, have known for 20 years, and you just met Jim a year ago. They had one cleaning, and Jim may leave and be super kind and genuine about it. Patients will leave. Someone will come back. I hope they find good dentists. I want them to use their dental insurance in a way that fits with their happiness. If it's coming to our practice and using it like a coupon, awesome. If finding an in-network provider is the most important thing for them and paying the least out of pocket, I totally get that too. Just be cool about it, right? It will affect your morale when a patient, and people will surprise you too. Patients you've known for years will leave, and someone you just met will want to stay. You can't guess. You don't know what happens inside of other people's heads. Analyze the fees and explore help. Prior to making a big shift, there are companies out there that can analyze your fees and look to negotiate with insurance companies. We have ones that sponsor the group. They've had major impact on the success of practices. One that I'm thinking about right now, a Nacho Dentist. If a company like this is able to get you $4 more for an adult pro fee and you do $2,000 a year, that's, you know, $8,000. The next 10 years, that's like an $80,000 increase in what you can make. Now, all of these companies will tell you they're not sure what they can get for you. They're not sure. It's a process, but it's a process well worth looking into. I've done it myself prior to being out of network totally. We had someone help us with a consultant like this. Hugely awesome impact. So text PPO to 215-798-9897 if you'd like to connect with one of these companies. They may be able to help you get better fees for doing the exact same work. Pretty cool. Make more money for literally doing nothing else. Remember, expect patients to be disappointed and show empathy and enthusiasm for how you can still maintain the relationship. When these patients will get letters from insurance companies, it does make it seem sometimes, I have no idea of the legal rules, what they're allowed to do. Seems kind of mean that they do this, but I'm not in charge of any of this. I'm just in charge of dealing with it. So if they send a letter saying, Dr. Nacho and his team don't take your insurance anymore, find an in-network provider. Yeah, I guess that could make me really frustrated. But I have the relationship with the patient. So you know what, Millie? Here's how this would work moving forward. Here's how we can be successful moving forward. Here's how you can stay in the office moving forward. Those are golden phrases. The way it works for us to maintain a relationship moving forward is XYZ. Here's how we've been successful moving forward, XYZ. Take control of the conversations in a competent and caring way. I'm going to check in on a question here. The insurance companies aren't dealing with anybody at this time. Yeah, they. Dr. Travis Campbell, who's coming to our event, and I highly recommend you text talk to 215-798-9897. We put in virtual ways to watch. We put in coaching programs. I mean, this is once in a lifetime, but this is an awesome opportunity for you to text talk to 215-798-9897 and select a menu option that works for you in your practice. Dr. Travis Campbell works with so many insurance plans every day and is very successful. We work with him in our own way. We do not adjust our fees at this time. Maybe 5 years from now, there's an insurance plan I do decide to go and network with. I'm sort of a never say never person. I'm just a embrace. I mean, maybe I'm never going to dunk. I think that's, I don't know if you can agree that I'm probably never going to dunk on a 10-foot rim, maybe a smaller rim, but maybe there's a plan in the future that's going to be something I want to participate with. Everything that matters needs a system, and everything matters, but make the best decision in the moment. So hopefully you develop value from this checklist. Feel free to take a screenshot of the checklist and, you know, use it with your team. I want to share with you a few more resources. So I like to make jokes, and I think you guys know this already. I like to make memes. You know, why can dentists, why are you paying us less? Because we can. And that's pretty much true. I went to the ADA in 2017 or 18. People asked, like, these dental insurance companies are paying us less. What's the deal? And they said, just because it's unfair doesn't make it illegal. Knowing they're going to pay dentists less, most of them are going to stay in network. They have a huge influx of new dentists, and some insurance plans are not allowing new providers to sign up at the same rate as more seasoned providers. While they say this is not age discrimination, because it's really for any new provider, the impact is, and this happened to me and my associate, is that the new dentists graduating are not able to join networks at higher fees. So literally, I can do a crown. I can do 50 crowns and my associate can do 50 crowns. And she's going to make like 0.7x what I make, 0.8x buys for the exact same work, the exact same lab expenses. These are challenges. So if you're thinking of reframing your relationship, you want an example letter. Once again, not recommending you drop, not recommending you sign up. But if you're reframing your relationship with one, two, or three plans, feel free to take a look at our letter. It's just an example. I wouldn't copy it. Read it and say, hey, if I was a patient, I would get it. If I was a patient, I'd be annoyed. So just a resource for you to do that. Since I have your attention in the moment, I was like to layer in a bonus video. This is all about words. Words are what matter. Words change the energy. Words make people happy or sad, but you got to say the words that are authentically genuine to you and reframe and create the energy you want. So I think us dentists, we say a lot of weird words. So it's a bonus video. Before we wrap up, I want to tell you five words you should not say in a dental office. And if you want some case acceptance tips from me that are totally free to test out in your office, text YAY to 215-798-9897 because I say it's always great when you can help patients say YAY and pay. And I want to let you know, no one's ever once said YAY. I've never said you would benefit from a crown. They never said YAY. They said, okay, Paul, I will do it. But it's an opportunity for you to get your team on board with verbal skills for case acceptance. Let's take a look in here.
Say words to you that make you feel weird, scared, and afraid. Well, it's not your dentist's fault because they went to dental school. And in dental school, we are taught to talk really, really weird. You may have a hygienist as well. She's also taught to talk really, really weird. My name is Dr. Paul Goodman, Dr. Nacho, and I am helping dentists and hygienists everywhere not talk weird. So I've come up with five words you should not say in a dental office. Five words that will make your patients feel scared, feel weird, feel afraid, and make you unlikable. So what are these five words? So we're gonna go through, don't say this, say this. The first word is fail or failed. There's no reason we have to look at a patient who's had a bridge in place for 20 years and say, Millie, your bridge has failed. It's unlikable, it's mean, and it doesn't even make sense because cars don't last that long. So instead of failed, how about we say this? Hey, Millie, it's time to replace your bridge. So don't say fail, say replace. What's next? My personal favorite, the one that makes you feel so weird on the inside when you say it. If a tooth does not have a filling, we are taught to call those teeth virgins. Does that make you feel comfortable to hear the word virgin? Instead of saying virgin, how about saying tooth without a filling. This tooth doesn't have a filling, not that it's a virgin. The third thing is save. We often say to patients, we can't save this tooth. So dramatic, like it's private premolar Ryan and Tom Hanks is coming to save it. So instead of that, say, hey, the cavity here has gotten so deep, we cannot maintain this tooth. So to review, don't say fail, say replace. Don't say virgin, say tooth without a filling. Don't say save, say maintain. We have two more. Informed consent, so dramatic. I'm gonna give you an informed consent for a root canal. Now, what could you call an informed consent? A heads up. I'm gonna give you a heads up what can happen. So you can have an informed consent form where it says informed consent, but as you bring it to life for patients, say, I'm gonna give you a heads up. Most of the time things go really, really well, but these are some things you should know about your procedure. I'm gonna give you a heads up, whether it's a root canal, scaling and root planing a crown. And the final one is the P word. Do not say this P word. And that P word is policy. No one likes to hear that word. You don't like it, I don't like it, and our patients don't like it. So you may have a financial policy where everyone pays before treatment. That's cool. But instead of saying policy, why don't you call it protocol? So don't say policy, say protocol. So these are the five words you should not say to be less weird and more likable in the dental office. Don't say fail, say replaced. Don't say virgin, say tooth without a filling. Don't say save, say maintained. Don't say informed consent, say heads up. Don't say policy, say protocol. If I can help you in any way, just reach out to me at dentalnachos.com. It is my life's goal to help you talk less weird. Give me some sort of like either a sign like this and I'll go. We are taught to talk really, really weird. Virgins, virgins, private premolar Ryan and Tom Hanks.
So hopefully you guys got some valuable tips. Don't say this, say this, to reframe the energy. I'd like to share with you, being a dentist is like being a Broadway star every single day, running a play that nobody really wants to see or pay for. I've strived to make that better for all of us. We've created 100 plus hours of on-demand CE content, career advice, patient communication tips. If you would like to pay $8 worth, that would be awesome. I can get some extra guac at Chipotle next time I'm there. But if you text Amanda 215-798-9897, it will give you a totally free pass to test it out for yourself. It's really a great opportunity. Story is the star of life. This is my brother and me, practice owners. He's our newest associate who we were able to get after one of our associates moved across the country. So replacing your associates is something I also help with through Dentist Job Connect. If you would like to get a CE series on what to ask on associate interviews, as well as how to be able to answer them as a practice owner, just text the word BURN to 215-798-9897. So I always like my shows to be like sitcom length. So we're coming up with 3 minutes left. If you have any questions in the chat, feel free to answer them. And I'll just share a last minute resource with you. But I really appreciate that you're here, part of the Dental Nachos world. Hope to meet you in person one day if you're watching on Zoom. If I've met you in person already, hope you come back for some Dental Nachos CE cheesesteaks and chips, nacho chips. Thanks, guys.
Think you're on the best level?
Do you need a dentisting coach? Someone to help you get to the next level? Is this your level and you want to get to the next level? What's wrong with your level? Your level stinks. What if you think you're on the best level? There's no such thing as that. If you even think you're on the best level, that's one of the limitations of your life. You can always get to the next level. I had a client once giving 110%. That stunk. I got him to use 114%. I don't know if that's how math works, but I can help you. I had one client who was so successful, he had a private jet. After working with me, he's now like Gary Vee. He wants to buy the New York Jets. My name is Dr. Paul Goodman, and all that is total nonsense. I'm a normal dentist coach. I'm a dentist myself. I help dentists buy practices, find jobs, hire their first associate, and most of all, just be happier, less grumbly in their dentisting life. It's like if we fed Mr. Grumbly nachos. If you reach out to us at dentalnachos.com or email us at salsa@dentalnachos.com, we have so many toppings to help you build your morale, make more money, deliver better patient care, and most of all, just be happier each day. So reach out to us at dentalnachos.com. I would love to help you.
Oh, I got some last minute questions. This is great. I didn't know it is. So after you, we can do bonus time. This is my favorite thing to do. So after you tell the patient you have shifted status and they ask, oh, so you're not out of network, what's the next thing you say to the patient? So shifting status is my version for dropping. So I do explain that we are not in network. I want to be authentic with them. I don't want in any way the patient to think that I'm not being truthful, but I just want to frame it in a positive way so that they have an opportunity to decide what's best for them. It could be as simple as people who had no out-of-pocket expense for a hygiene visit now have $28 out-of-pocket. And to them, that's no big deal. To someone else, that's a big deal. We find out for them. Really great question there. So I look to have these conversations and share about insurance as much as possible. I'm very passionate, some would say obsessive, about telling patients how insurance works. Even if they don't have insurance, I just tell everybody. Maybe they tell a friend. So you know dental insurance, not really insurance, more like a coupon. Coupon that has benefits, but blackout dates and restrictions like airline miles. But at our practice, if you or someone else has insurance, we do the best job possible to maximize the benefit of your coupon and let patients decide from there. So I really appreciate that last minute question. I know who asked that. I love what you contribute into the Nachoverse. Hope you come to Philly and hang with us in person. And if you want to watch any of our unlimited dental nacho C and career advice content, just text Amanda to 215-798-9897.